We start off every Friday with Where is College Game Day from ESPN going to go for the next week? So next week is week 11. I've got five options for you. We will start off with this one. Oklahoma at Baylor next week. Now, Baylor is hosting TCU this week. You know, I would imagine they will get that one done. Of course, you never know in a rivalry like that. How do you feel about that if they were to make the leap to Baylor?
I wouldn't hate it, but it's not my favorite choice by any stretch.
The next one I've got, NC State at Wake Forest. Of course, Wake Forest would have to get through North Carolina, and you would probably need NC State to get a win at Florida State. Wake Forest, a short underdog on the road. NC State, a short favorite on the road. I would like to see them in Wake Forest next week. I think that'd be a lot of fun because I don't know how many opportunities you're going to get within about a decade of going to Wake Forest. How you feel about that one?
That's it. That's the place. That's the place you need to go. And I don't care what NC State does, by the way. Wake Forest is undefeated, NC State has been good enough to justify going there.
I tend to agree. Did you see the stat where, what was it? NC State, Wake Forest had like 83% of their student body at their most recent home game against Duke.
Well, yeah, but they have like the smallest enrollment in the country.
Right, but the fact that they got like 83% of all of their students at the game was pretty crazy to me. That's a high number.
I mean, yeah, but that's okay. Yeah, percentages are easier to get when you're little.
Agreed.
Five people show up out of 100, you got 5%. Okay, sure. If five people show up out of 10, you got 50%.
I see what you're saying. It's just, surprising considering this is not exactly known as a football hotbed. There's not a ton of students that typically care about the football program, but they are bought in right now. So I do think that would be a fascinating spot. I wrote down Minnesota at Iowa. They have not been to Kinnick this year. Iowa's been on a downturn here.
They missed their chance to go to Kinnick. Shame on them. That's on them.
Yeah, I tend to agree. Minnesota, kind of a shocking story right now, but, things are about to get...
Minnesota's been awesome, but yeah. No, they're not game day worthy right now.
I don't think so. Mississippi State at Auburn. If State can get a win against Arkansas and Auburn gets a win against A&M, maybe they head to the Plains?
No, because I think they're going to end up doing Mississippi State. They're going to go to the Iron Bowl, so you don't want to set yourself up to go to the same school, two out of three weeks. Like we did with Georgia.
Yeah, that's true. And then last one, Texas A&M at Ole Miss. Ole Miss, of course, hosting Liberty. That one could be fun.
That one, if for some reason Wake Forest loses and the wheels come off there and something happens in the Baylor, I think that's an interesting game. I think it's a fun game. Ole Miss got a couple of losses under the belt now, but I don't think either of those losses are anything to sniff about, so...
Yeah, I mean, it would be two lost teams. Of course, A&M, we would have to get them through Auburn this weekend at home at Kyle Field. So I guess our prediction, our hope, is that they go to Wake Forest next week. And then second, of course, would probably be Oklahoma-Baylor and then A&M Ole Miss in that order. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.